Amy Butler. I'm a research physicist at NOAA in the Chemical Sciences Laboratory. I was originally a federal employee at the NOAA Climate Prediction Center in Washington, D.C. And then we moved back to Colorado, which is where I'm from. And so I moved to the NOAA in Boulder. And I spent 6 years as a contractor at NOAA CSL. And then the last year and a half, I became a federal employee again. So my area of research is studying the stratosphere and the winds in the stratosphere called the polar vortex. And to understand the polar vortex, there's a few things we need to understand. The first is what causes seasons in the first place. And we have seasons because the Earth is tilted on its axis as it circles around the sun. And this means that during some times of year, the northern hemisphere is tilted towards the sun so that it receives more direct sunlight. And this is our summer. As the Earth keeps rotating around the sun, the northern hemisphere starts to tilt away from the sun, and this is called winter. So what does this have to do with the jet stream? The jet stream forms primarily because the Earth is not heated evenly by the sun, but gets more heat at the equator and less heat at the pole. So this difference in temperature, plus the rotation and tilt of the Earth, is what drives the major air currents on our planet. And the jet stream is a band of fast-moving winds in the mid-latitude region that blows from west to east. And this band of winds is typically strongest 5 to 9 miles above the Earth's surface. And it typically marks the boundary between warm and cold air masses or weather patterns. The jet stream is associated with this cold weather because when the jet stream moves south, it allows cold air from close to the pole to flow south. And similarly, when the jet stream moves north, it allows air closer to the equator to flow north. So sometimes the jet stream swings really far south and it allows air that's been sitting over the pole or the Arctic to come pouring down into the mid-latitudes. Now, usually this just happens randomly. There's not a cause. The atmosphere is chaotic and the jet stream changes position a lot. That's why it's sunny one day and rainy the next. It's just weather. This ties into the polar vortex and why it's important. So similar to the jet stream, the polar vortex is also a band of winds flowing from west to east, but it has some features distinct from the jet stream. It's a unique feature. For one thing, the polar vortex is much higher than the jet stream. It typically flows 10 to 30 miles above the surface, and it circles the pole in a region called the stratosphere. And for another thing, the polar vortex only forms in the winter, while the jet stream is around year-round. So the reason we care about the polar vortex is that the strength of its winds can influence the jet stream below it, sometimes for weeks at a time. So for example, sometimes in winter, the polar vortex winds slow way down or even reverse direction entirely. And when this happens, it can make the jet stream slow down and move south by nudging it and bringing cold Arctic air with it. And most importantly, because the polar vortex affects the jet stream for days to weeks, when we see the winds changing in the polar stratosphere, we can predict that really cold winter weather is more likely for certain regions far in advance. And so this allows us to plan ahead by making sure power sources are ready to support more energy use and transportation managers are prepared to treat roads for ice and snow. There has been a lot of research recently that some of it is suggesting that perhaps when you lose sea ice due to climate change, that could potentially make the jet stream wavier and make the polar vortex weaker. So this is a really important question because the idea is that maybe it could even get colder in the future, or at least you could have more extreme weather in the winter if this mechanism was true. And so a lot of attention has gone into try to simulate this in climate models. And there is some agreement that if nothing else was going on, a loss of sea ice would indeed give you a weaker polar vortex and potentially colder weather in some areas. However, in the real world, that's not the only thing going on because climate change is affecting everything globally. And so there's also changes in the tropics that can change the polar vortex and the jet stream in the opposite way. And so which of these things win out in the end is really unknown, especially in the Northern Hemisphere. And so the short answer is we don't know what will happen, especially with the polar vortex. There's no agreement at all in climate models, even on the sign of the change. So whether it will strengthen or weaken, some models suggest a really strong strengthening, some models suggest a really strong weakening. And so it's just really unclear. But what is certain is that it will have an effect on the uncertainty with which we can predict how strong these changes in mid-latitude weather will be in the future, because it can have such a big influence in wintertime. What we're mostly going to see is that as climate change continues to occur, it's going to get warmer. And I think that's very clear in all the models, that overwhelmingly the increasing CO2 effects on our temperatures is going to overwhelm changes due to the polar vortex. The polar vortex just adds a little bit of uncertainty into how strong that warming is going to be.